फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू लुकमान आईएएस। सो फ्रेंड्स, वंस अगेन वी आर विद अ न्यू वीडियो एंड इन फैक्ट दिस वीडियो इज कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ द प्रीवियस वीडियो स्ट्रेटजी फॉर प्रीलिम्स। सो फ्रेंड्स, इन द पार्ट वन इटसेल्फ वी डिस्कस दैट वी शुड अडॉप्ट अ स्मार्ट स्ट्रेटजी एंड इन फैक्ट इन दैट केस वी डिस्कस्ड टू वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स। वन इज दैट द सिलेबस ऑफ प्रीलिम्स इज इलस्ट्रेटिव, नॉट एग्जॉस्टिव, एंड दैट्स वाई वी नीड टू गो थ्रू द क्वेश्चंस, पास्ट ईयर क्वेश्चंस ऑफ यूपीएससी। एंड द सेकेंड थिंग दैट वी डिस्कस्ड इज दैट फॉर प्रीलिम्स ऑल्सो वी शुड स्टडी द रिटन सिलेबस ऑल्सो टाइम एंड अगेन, बिकॉज द रिटन सिलेबस ऑफ जीएस पेपर 1, 2, 3 दे आर इन फैक्ट डिटेलिंग ऑफ द सिलेबस फॉर प्रीलिम्स फ्रेंड्स। सो दीज टू थिंग्स आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। Now friends, one question arises, why there is need to know the demand of the exam and the syllabus of the exam? Because when we study these two things that we discussed in the smart strategy, then the outcome is that we come to understand the demand of the exam and also the syllabus of the exam. So the benefit is that friend, after having understood these things, we come to know what is the demand of the UPSC, what exactly the UPSC asks. How UPSC frames question. This is how we will understand by going through the various question papers of UPSC. The second thing is that what exactly UPSC want us to know. This is one thing. The first thing is that how they are framing the question. The second thing is that what UPSC wants us to know. The third is that what to study and what not to study. And this is one of the very much crucial point, crucial strategy in a UPSC examination, not only for the prelims but also for mains, written interview, all those things, that what to study and what not to study. So we will understand these things only when we know the syllabus and only when we know that what UPSC is demanding, what is the expectations of UPSC from an aspirant. And the second thing is that what should be the range and the depth of a study. So the various things, the width and horizon of knowledge that we should have to qualify this examination, that also will come to our mind. We will start to understand these things also after going through the UPSC questions papers time and again and the reading the syllabus time and again. Again, the thing is that the important topics we will come to know. For example, a given topic is there, and from there UPSC is always asking question. So those things we will always, while going through the newspapers, that will come to our mind, at the first instant itself, that it is very important for UPSC. So these are the benefits of understanding the demand of the exam and the syllabus of the exam. And in fact, it will help in optimization of the time, friends. Optimization of time management is very important. And the second thing is that it will keep a candidate focused and confined to the exact pattern of the exam, to the point focus. This is how we say, friends. Therefore, the two things that we emphasized upon was reading the question papers time and again and reading the syllabus time and again. These two things are very much essential, friends. Now, after having discussed all these things, friends, now let us have a quick overview of the subject-wise strategy, friends. So let us first take history. So on an average, 50 to 20 questions are asked from history, including art and culture, modern history, all those things. And for this, friends, the best resource is NCERT book itself from 6th to 12th class. And in fact, the benefit of 6th to 12th class history books is that it will cover art and culture also, and also the modern history. In fact, for modern history, there is also one very good book, old NCERT book, Bipin Chandra, 12th class. That is also very good. Although the book does not cover the period after 1940 very clearly. Therefore, the role of a spectrum for modern history is also very good. So these things, these books are very much sufficient for the preparation of history, friends. And for ancient India, R.S. Sharma is one very good book. And for medieval India, Satish Chandra is also very good book. Friends, after these things, after these resources, Lukman printed notes we also provide, and there is also very good GS Foundation class notes from our institution. So these are the various resources that you can refer to, friends, and you can study. And the approach to study history is that we should study history in a chronological manner and by linking the events through the forward and backward linkages. This will help us to create an insight, a depth into the understanding of history, and it will help in solving various questions rather than only by cramming things. Friends, here one very important aspect is that in case of history, we cannot read everything exhaustively, that we have covered history by 100%. This can never be done in reality, in practicality, friends. It is very difficult. But the thing is that when these standard books are and these standard resources are consulted, then there is more likelihood of solving more and more of the questions, friends. And in fact, what is the cutoff every year? Not more than 60%. दिस इज हाउ वी हैव द कट ऑफ, दैट मीन्स वी डोंट हैव टू बी 100%. दिस इज वॉट आई एम आर्गुइंग फॉर फ्रेंड्स. देन कम्स द जियोग्राफी एंड एवरेज 15 to 20 क्वेश्चन आर आस्क्ड हेयर ऑल्सो इफ वी सेग्रीगेट द एनवायरमेंट सेक्शन एज सच. For geography also friends, the NCERT books are very important from 9th class to 12th class. Each and every line, each and every chapter is very important from NCERT books. And in fact, those books should be read religiously and should be understood, should be in fact read in such manner that those things, those concepts do not go into the brain only but percolate into the heart also. That is, the understanding is developed, because in geography we can see many questions are directly asked from NCERT books, and many a times if questions are not directly asked but the concepts given in NCERT can help in resolving and solving those questions. So this is one very good aspect friends. And in addition to that, we can see for other resources also. For example, Savinder Singh is for physical geography, G.C. Leong is also a very good book. And of course, Lukman printed geography notes, we have also prepared this, and we have very good resource in this case. And GS Foundation class notes are also very good. And the Lukman current affairs also help in preparing map related questions, because map related questions are largely from current affairs related. For example, Syria was in news, so that area became important for map location. Then Turkey was in news, that became important. So there are various places on the globe which become important because of being in news. So by covering the current affairs, we can prepare the map related questions also. Further friends, here we must emphasize that atlas, focus on atlas is very much needed, and mapping is in fact not one day process that in one day you will cover mapping. It is in fact a regular practice, and every day, each passing day, you should see the map, the global, the world map. And every day you should look at various parts of the globe and try to keep that in mind. So it is an evolving process, continuous process. In fact, it takes time throughout your study. Friends, some hot spots also are there. For example, Central Asia, West Asia, these things in fact they are news in also very often. We can see them in news also. Some cities and countries are in news. So that location and the places nearby should also be studied for mapping section. So this is how the geography can be prepared friends. Now let us come to the next very important topic, and this is Indian polity. Average 10 to 15 questions are asked if we segregate governance here. So for Indian polity, we must read PM Bakshi friends. It is very important, because reading PM Bakshi lets us know what is given in the constitution, and once we know what is given in the constitution, at the same time we also come to know what is not given in the constitution. So knowing the constitution is very important friends, because in the prelim syllabus also Indian constitution has been specifically and very explicitly mentioned. So knowing the constitution is very important. So PM Bakshi book, Bear Act, should be necessarily read friends. Then comes the role of Lakshmikant. Lakshmikant is very important book, because it covers various factuals and various concepts also not given in PM Bakshi, not given in constitution, and also various different concepts, topics are also covered in Lakshmikant. For example, various non-constitutional bodies are also covered in Lakshmikant. So Lakshmikant is a very good source for Indian polity. Generally candidates go through Lakshmikant friends. And then friends, NCERT books are also needed for polity, because many a times we can see UPSC is focusing on some basic understanding given in those books. For example, the concept of liberty, it was asked in 2019 prelims, and such concepts are given there in political theories class 11th NCERT. So NCERT books should also be read friends, at least 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th classes should be read. This is very important. And then friends, our Indian polity preparation should be supplemented by S. Ansari sir's notes, because these notes are very comprehensive and they cover various aspects of Indian polity in a very conceptual manner. So that helps not only in prelims and not only in written but also in interview. That means those notes are very comprehensive, covering all the stages of this examination. And further, Lukman current affairs material and editorial discussion, these are very good resources, because Indian polity also constitutes several aspects from the current ongoing events friends. So these things should also be taken into consideration. Next comes governance friends. From governance section, generally 5 to 7 questions are asked. And see friends, for governance we need to have some basic understanding also. For example, what is meaning of governance? what is meaning of good governance, e-governance, accountability, transparency. These various conceptual framework should be there in mind, friends. It is very important. And for that also, S. Ansari sir's notes are very much helpful. They cover these things very comprehensively. Once we are aware of these concepts, then some question coming from, say, Right to Information Act. So there we are quite able to solve that question in the prelims also. Then we should supplement these notes and these concepts with current events, friends, such as various government policies that are in news or that are coming from the side of government every now and then. And in this case, friends, again, Lukman current affairs materials and editorial discussion, they are very much helpful because they are comprehensive, extensive. And also we provide Lukman booklet on government schemes, various commissions, committees, and class notes are also very important, friends. Class notes that S. Ansari sir's notes we have discussed just above. Now, friends, after governance, the role of environment as a subject is also very important. And average 15 to 20 questions are asked from environment. And this section is very important because civil services examination for this IAS IPS is combined with the preliminary examination for Indian Forest Service. Therefore, the importance of environment section is increases always. Now, friends, how to study for environment? So the first thing is that for environment, we must have a good understanding of basic science. Basic science is very important. Basic biology, basic physics, basic chemistry. These are very important for understanding the various aspects of environment, the conceptual aspect of environment. And we can cite some examples also, friends. For example, lichens was asked in exam. Prelims paper, it was asked. This lichens is given in 7th class science book. So general science understanding is very important for solving environment related questions. Then again, friends, we need to have some basic physics also, because without knowing the basic physics, we cannot understand the space science, space related various aspects, orbits and the different types of satellites and their help in the preservation of environment. For example, we need to understand the role of electromagnetic radiation, what is it is and how they are used to analyze the health of crops. So these various things are there. Therefore, there is large scale overlapping between general science and environment. For example, in case of climate change also, there also climate change is not only about environment, but climate change is also related to the application of various basic science. Similarly, plastic waste. Plastic waste is not only about being an environmental issue, but plastic waste has also something to do with the general science. That's why there is quite overlapping between general science and environment, and both will supplement and complement each other, friends. And also here, the role of ICSE board class 9th and class 10th books are very much important, friends. And also current events relating to environment and international agreements, convention that are going on, they are very much important. For example, climate change related aspects are there. From there, UPSC is fond of asking questions, friends. So these things should be kept in mind. And here also, friends, the Lukman current affairs notes will help for covering the various international agreements, conventions regarding environment. And editorial discussion for clarifying various concepts also. GS Foundation class notes are also very good in this aspect for general science and environment, friends. Now comes the role of economics. And see, friends, economics also covers a major portion of the syllabus and questions. In fact, for this, macroeconomics 12th class and economic development 11th class NCERT, they are very much important, friends, and we must read that religiously. And because the significance of reading these books, two books, is that we will be conceptually very strong. And in fact, from economics, there are two types of questions that are asked. One is the core understanding that is required in economics. For example, money multiplier related concept that was asked in 2019 prelims. We discussed in part one video. Similarly, the second way from which economics related questions are there are from current events. And in 2019 itself, current related aspect was that the position of India in terms of GDP in PPP terms, this was asked. So current related events are also asked. So from economics, for economics, if we see, friends, then two things we have to keep in mind: the conceptual aspect should be very strong, and second, the current events related aspect should be very much clear. We should be clear about those things and should have a good understanding of those current events also, friends. Therefore, for current aspects, macroeconomics 12th class, and these things are important, economic development 11th class, and the second is that for current events, newspaper articles should be read. Now see, friends, when newspaper articles are read relating to economic issues, then in that article also various conceptual aspects of economics become very clear. For example, C. Rangarajan, we can often find him writing in The Hindu on current economic issues, and he uses very much fundamental concepts of economics. And whenever we find any difficulty, internet is one very good source to understand that terminology, that concept of the economics. This is how economics should be prepared. And in fact, it is very important aspect, friend. Economics is one determining subject for qualifying UPSC prelims. And in this case also, friends, Lukman current affairs materials are very much important, because economics related current affairs are also very much, we can see so much of economics related the current affairs material things in news. And in this case also, editorial discussion classes, which clarifies the concepts and also helps in preparation of not only prelims but also written examination and interview also, of course. GS Foundation class notes are also there for the basics of economics. That should also be consulted, friends, for the basic understanding of economics, because in case of macroeconomics, class 12th, many things we may not find. That we will find in the GS Foundation class notes, friends. Then comes the role of current affairs, friends. And in case of current affairs, average 20 to 25 questions are asked. And in case of current affairs, in fact, if we will go through current affairs, then we will see that various basic and traditional questions are also linked with the current affairs. Therefore, its significance is so much. And also quite a large number of questions are asked from current affairs. So the strategy should be that we should at least read one newspaper religiously, like The Hindu or Indian Express. One newspaper should be religiously followed, and every day it should be followed. And then we should also follow Lukman current affairs related supplement and the editorial discussion. These things also comprehensively cover the current events from the perspective of UPSC and the demand of the exam. And friends, revision time and again, that is very important for current affairs also. And in fact, if we conclude our discussion, friends, then we should have width and depth of the knowledge. If we want to have the best strategy for prelims preparation, then it is to have width and depth of the knowledge. This is one thing, friends, that we must have, must keep in mind. Friends, here one thing I forgot to tell you, for current affairs, we should read newspaper. But how to read newspaper, that should also be learned, because it is also an art. We should read the newspaper through the prism of UPSC, through the prism of syllabus of UPSC, through the prism of demand of the questions asked by UPSC. So this should be learned by friends, and it will be learned by practice, and also by going through the questions and syllabus of the UPSC time and again, friends. This is very important. Now, friends, what can be the role of Lukman PT test series? So this is a sort of practice, friends. Why a sort of practice, and how it can be helpful, friends? Because we go through so many tests and in that test we solve so many questions also, then we come to know that which subjects we are not good at, and it requires our special focus. So this one thing is that weakness comes clear to us. So test series, Lukman PT test series, very important for this aspect. Second, what type of mistakes we are committing? Because friends, many a times we may commit a mistake because we have lack of knowledge, but many a times we commit a mistake because although we have knowledge, but we are not able to apply that knowledge. So lack of application of knowledge may also be one reason that we are committing mistakes. So these things become clear when we go for the Lukman PT test series. So these things help us in having a good practice, friends. And then the role of guidance by Lukman team also comes. In fact, friends, a person may be able to study any subject, for example, history on own, but he or she may not be able to understand other subjects. For example, he may be good at history, but may not be good at science or economy. Similarly, different subjects require core understanding, because there is cutthroat competition, friends, and many candidates are not qualifying barely by 1 or 2 marks. Therefore, the cutthroat competition is there, and therefore a candidate is expected to have a good conceptual clarity of the core of any subject, friends. And knowing a subject is different from knowing how to from knowing it to qualify the exam, friends. देन कम्स द रोल ऑफ एक्सपर्ट्स ऑल्सो, बिकॉज एक्सपर्ट्स ऑफ गिवेन सब्जेक्ट एंड ईयर्स ऑफ एक्सपीरियंस इन सिविल सर्विसेज एग्जामिनेशन, दे हेल्प अस इन आवर प्रिपरेशन विथ बोथ कॉन्फिडेंस मोटिवेशन एंड ऑल्सो द एडिक्वेट एंड प्रॉपर गाइडलाइन फ्रेंड्स. एंड दिस इज हाउ फ्रेंड्स वी हैव डिस्कस्ड फॉर स्ट्रेटजी फॉर पेपर वन. Now, in a quick review, friends, quick view, let us see the strategy for paper 2. Paper 2 is qualifying, friends, with 33% marks. But see, friends, we should not be casual while preparing for paper 2, that it is qualifying in nature. Because many a times, some people perform very well in paper 1, but they are unable to qualify in paper 2. Therefore, for paper 2, we should give due respect. It is very important in overall preparation. And the practice must be done sufficiently before going to the exam. Before going to the exam, practice must be sufficiently done. And also, friends, we should not only focus on that we will be solving only maths or we will be solving only English comprehension. No, friends. Because maybe you are going for English comprehension, but that year English comprehension is very tough. So you will be in a lurch. Therefore, we should in fact practice for both comprehension and quantitative aptitude, friends. In fact, in our opinion, 30 days before the prelims examination date, we should start practicing for paper 2 and solving previous year UPSC CSAT paper 2 question paper. Friends, here also our institute provides expert guidance on English comprehension and various quantitative aptitude, friends. So this is how, friends, our strategy for prelims is here. Now in the coming videos, we will be discussing about a strategy for written examination also. By that time, friends, please share your comments, give us your feedback. You are always welcome for that. Thank you, friends. Thank you so much.